During the past year, we've been observing several important trends in targeted attacks, and our conclusions and predictions are based on observing attacks such as NetTraveler, which we announced in June 2013, IceFog, and a few others which allow us to have a broader view of the trends in the most sophisticated kinds of targeted attacks. So first of all, we observe the emergence of cyber mercenary groups. These are smaller groups of hackers between 5 and 10 people, sometimes fluent in multiple languages such as English, Chinese, Japanese, and Korean at the same time, targeting the supply chain in very, very fast operations, lightning strikes of cyber attacks, which allows them to access files from the victim's machines, copy them very quickly, clean up and get out. Another trend which we observed the last year, and believe it will become more important in the future, is increased sophistication of targeted attacks. And that includes the development of exploits for mobile components, other operating systems such as OS X, for instance, or even Solaris, that is very popular with database systems. So overall, we can see that the number of targeted attacks will grow, the sophistication of these attacks will grow, and the diversity of the attacks will grow. But at the same time, the number of groups involved in targeted attacks will increase as they split into smaller groups running lightning strikes, faster surgical precision kind of attacks. What does it all mean for enterprises and businesses? First, the number of targeted attacks will increase, and we think that we are going to see more attacks against sectors which have previously been spared from this kind of incidents. For instance, pharmaceutical sector, the supply chain. I would say that pretty much everyone is at risk from targeted attacks. Also, when it comes to who is behind targeted attacks, in general, we have three categories of people or entities behind targeted attacks. That include governments and nation states. The second one would be hacktivists. And the third one would be cyber criminals, people who do this for money. The number of incidents which are associated with nation states is on the increase as well. And I would say that this is one of the biggest issues at the moment. The fact that the trust between nation states is eroding, and there are pretty much no limits in what nation states can attack in order to obtain advantages such as geopolitical advantages. For a business, this means that there is a need to increase the levels of protections in the network. It's very important to lock up all devices, including mobile devices, as well as any operating system different than Windows, such as Linux, for instance, or macOS. It's also very important to come up with a solid security policy. And here our recommendation is to implement default deny policies. Default deny policies prevent the execution of untrusted code in your enterprise environment. What it means is that even if the attackers find a way to inject malware in your systems, they will not be able to successfully execute it because the products will not recognize it as untrusted software. Therefore, this is one of the most efficient methods to protect against targeted attacks. The question we are hearing a lot from our customers is, how can I defend against the most advanced forms of attacks? And it's very important to understand that when it comes to sophisticated adversaries, no matter how many precautions you take, they will eventually find a way in your network. And that can be either through social engineering, misconfigurations of the network, unprotected wireless access points, bring your own device kind of mentality, or even computers which do not have security solutions. So this is why it's important to take precautions, and what we say is just to prepare for the worst. Make sure that the network is well separated and the information that is most valuable is behind several layers of firewalls. If the attackers manage to access your confidential information, it's important to have a DLP solution which can track the exfiltration of the data from your networks. Finally, we believe it's quite important to keep everything updated and to patch all third-party software. And our products include solutions which can allow you to identify all software and to find the right way to upgrade that software without compromising any processes from your enterprise. So overall, there are solutions to even to the most advanced threats. The customers and the entities that are targeted by these attacks are well prepared in advance, these attacks can be very well mitigated and they can be prevented.